Carpool with us today. She's got a lot of exciting stuff coming up. Tell us a little bit about your pageant background.
Okay, so actually I got started with pageants a little bit in middle school. I'm currently going to be a junior at the University of Arkansas, so I haven't been doing it as long as most girls, but I won my first title back in 2018, and that was Miss Texarkana. And then I decided again to compete the next year, again in the same organization, the Miss Texarkana Twin Rivers organization, and thankfully won the Miss Twin Rivers title, because you can't be Miss Texarkana back-to-back. You kind of have to switch out. Mm-hmm. So I've just been doing it, I would say, approximately 5 to 6 years. For the longest time, I had the first runners-up curse. Every pageant I competed in, I would win first runner-up. So I just got really discouraged for a little bit and took about a year or two off. And then decided to compete for Miss Texarkana, and that's when I finally broke the curse. So
okay, good. So, of course, coming up in the next, what, just couple weeks, you have Miss Texas,
it's
right?
It's about 10 days. I'm, like, counting down now. Yeah. I think I get more nervous every day.
That's, you know, I had the privilege of going with you last year. My daughter Stella was your Lone Star Princesses.
Yes.
And we really got to see, you know, what it's all about. And it's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work. And I always tell people, like, you think, oh, pageants, like, she just has to get on stage and, like, walk around. But there's so much more behind it than, like, what the normal person sees that's not involved in, like, the Miss America organization. I mean, it's a lot. Like, it entitles practicing every day on your talent. I'm doing acro jazz, so that's dancing and tumbling. So I'm doing it about 5 times every day to build my stamina for the stage.
Oh, wow.
And then just even Stella at the Lone Star Princess, like, week of Miss Texas, like, they had them doing a ton of stuff.
Oh, yeah. We were busy. I did not expect to be that busy.
I did not expect y'all to be that busy either. I was like, oh, my gosh, they're having these little ones do something all day, every day.
And that was just a portion of what you did. So, but it was really neat to see you go through that process, because other than just seeing you on stage, we got to see you practicing and, you know, just everything leading up to the big moment. So
it's a lot. I'm excited to get there and get started. Of course, I'm always a little bit nervous because this is only my second year competing at Miss Texas. So I'm just ready to get there, see how this year goes. I feel like this year I'm a lot more confident going into Miss Texas, just because I've already got that first round knocked out.
Yeah.
So I'm ready to go back and then hopefully place higher this year and see what happens. Maybe I'll come back Miss Texas.
Yeah, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
We are so excited for you. So we wish you the best.
And I think
that you're going to do amazing. So,
thank you.
So what would you say that your favorite part of pageants is?
I think my favorite part, honestly, is just, I know without a crown, I can go out into the community and talk about my platform and just get to know people in the community and make connections. But for some reason, this crown and this sash makes it a lot easier for people to be willing to talk to you. And you get invited to do a lot more things in the community. I've went to local schools like Liberty Isle, Pleasant Grove, Texas Elementary School, and just read to the kids and kind of talked about my platform a little bit. But I think going out into the community and being able to, like, spread my knowledge of kindness and all that kind of stuff, and then my platform Stroke Awareness, is just kind of what's made this, like, all this work.
So tell us a little bit about your platform, Stroke Awareness, because I guess everybody going to Miss Texas has to have a platform.
Yes,
right?
Everyone has a platform. Some examples of other girls is, like, suicide prevention or anti-bullying campaigns, stuff like that. And actually, when I first started pageantry, I picked substance abuse prevention for my platform because that was something that was kind of close to my heart. And then in 2016, my grandma had a stroke. And I was like, you know what? I really want to dig deep in my platform and find something that really has a strong meaning for me and something I can really advocate for and really on a like a more personal level kind of speak about. So my grandma had her stroke in 2016. It was super scary. I mean,
yeah.
My grandma is my best friend. We're super close. Very, very, very close. And so almost losing her, I was like, oh, like we never would have ever thought she would have had a stroke. And so thank the Lord, she knew the signs and symptoms as well as my grandpa, and they were able to act quick enough to get her to the hospital with her having minor damage to her brain. And so once I kind of went through that, I was like, you know what, this is stroke awareness and the signs and symptoms to prevent a stroke and to recognize a stroke is something that I feel like everyone in the world, everyone in our community needs to be educated on.
Uh-huh.
I mean, there's simple signs and symptoms that if you think something's wrong with someone that you can check for, and if you're able to act quick enough, it can save their life or even save your own life.
Yeah,
so exactly. That's something I really just kind of got close with in the last 2 years. Something that I really advocated for and, you know, done fundraisers for and just really try to spread the word because lucky enough, my grandma was able to save her life, and I would love for that, for someone else to have that ability too.
Yeah, okay. So what would you say the toughest part of being a title holder would be?
I think the toughest part has to be balancing it, like balancing the school aspect of it, like going to school. I go to school in the University of Arkansas, but I'm a Texarkana title holder. So I think going to school and then also being able to go out into my community during the school year is something that's really tough. You know, I have a job in Fayetteville. I'm a full-time student. I really care about having good grades. So coming home every weekend to do small little things or do community activities was not really something that was very possible for me.
Uh-huh.
Of course, when I could, when I had a free weekend, I always was here. But that's a little bit inconvenient when you live 4.5 hours away.
Yeah,
it gas is a lot of money when you're a college student.
Uh-huh.
So I think that's the toughest part. But the competing aspect of it, I think, is having to expand your knowledge with everything that's going on in the world. I mean, you have to know everything that's happening in the news, and not only you have to know what's happening, you have to have an opinion on it. An opinion that's not going to make people mad, but an opinion that the judges know is your own formulated opinion.
So what's a fun fact about you? Maybe something that people would be like, oh, that's cool.
Well, my name is Jasmine. I like to say I'm named after Princess Jasmine. I don't know if that's 100% true, but that's what I like to go off of. And my favorite color is purple. I think I got that from Princess Jasmine, too, because she has that purple dress on in the cartoon movie.
Uh-huh.
I can do 12 standing backflips in a row.
Okay.
So standing tucks in a row.
You know we're going to make you do that when we stop the car, right?
Oh, gosh.
Okay.
Let's try it. Let's try it in my heels. I've never done it before, but today might be the day.
Well, wait. We'll have to. We'll need proof. No, I'm just kidding. No, we totally believe you. So, okay, since you love Princess Jasmine so much, what would be your favorite movie then?
Definitely 100% Aladdin. I love the cartoon version, but I fell in love with this newer version that's in the movie theaters right now. I mean, I felt like a child watching the movie. Like, yeah. I was up in my seat dancing, singing. I was is great. I literally think I've been waiting 18 years for that new version to come out.
Okay.
And I was so excited. It was amazing. DJ Kelly.
Too late, y'all done wound me up. Too late, y'all done wound me up. About to show you what I'm working with.
Show me what you're working with.
It's the Alibaba, it's the Big Baba, it's the blue. Handsome, jazzing like the flower, it's the
Mister.
Tell me whatever you need.
Never had a friend, never had a friend.
Jasmine, Miss Twin Rivers on this carpool. So June 21st through 29th. Yes, will be Miss Texas.
A whole week long.
So she, follow her on Facebook. You have your Facebook page, right?
Yeah, Twin Rivers. I have Miss Twin Rivers 2019 on Facebook.
Okay.
Or you can follow me on Instagram, and that's at Miss Twin Rivers 2019 also, if you want to keep up with my journey to Miss Texas.
Yes, okay, so be sure to do that. So follow her on Facebook, follow her on Instagram. We can see everything as it goes down on Miss Texas Week, and we wish you the best of luck. I know that you have a special place in our hearts, and we're so happy and excited for you, so good luck. We hope that you bring the Miss Texas crown to
Texarkana. Oh, thank you. I hope so, too. And Thumb Pros and Texarkana Marketing Agency is going to be the first place I stop whenever I bring back the Miss Texas crown. So, fingers crossed. Because that would be, I think that would just be so cool to, like, have a Texarkana homegirl. And that's why I think this whole Miss Twin Rivers and Miss Texarkana title means so much to me, because I am a hometown girl. I mean, I was born and raised in Texarkana. So, it would just be so awesome to have everyone supporting to come back as Miss Texas and represent for this community.
Yeah,
well, be awesome.
Hopefully, stay tuned.
Bye.